Hello all, welcome to today's lecture where we are going to talk about a uniform circular motion and the kinematics part of it. Okay, so kinematics is when we are interested in velocity, displacement and acceleration. Okay, that is the kinematics part of it. When we only talk about what is its displacement, what is its velocity and what is its acceleration, we'll talk about it. And dynamics part, when I teach Newton's laws of motion, then we'll take the dynamics part of it. Okay, now to start with, uniform circular motion, as the name says, that in uniform circular motion speed remains constant. And of course, as the name suggests, it's circular motion, so speed is remaining constant and it is describing a circle. Okay, now we'll look into it. Now if you take example of uniform circular motion, there are, in uniform circular motion, it will, the thing has to move with constant speed. Okay, now generally we talk about, like, this, if I describe a circle with this one, so this is almost a uniform circular motion. Okay, I am describing a circle in, let us say, xy plane. This is called vertical circular motion. Okay, now so the thing is going with constant speed. But if it slows down, that is non-uniform. If it speeds up, that is non-uniform. Okay. Now, same way, if I describe a circle in this plane, this will be called as a horizontal circular motion. Okay. So, when it goes like this is vertical circular motion. When it goes like this is horizontal circular motion. Now, when you switch on your fan, the motion is not uniform. The particles of the fan, they slowly, the blades, particles of the fan, they slowly pick up the speed. So for some time it is non-uniform until it attains the full speed. So suppose you put it on 5, your fan is, suppose you put your knob, regulator knob, at highest speed. So it will take some time. During that time, it will have non-uniform motion, then it will attain the full speed. Okay, now actually this dealing with fan or any solid body, we'll discuss it later, that is called rigid body dynamics. Here we have to just imagine that suppose you are having a stone attached with a string and you are making it go in a circle, and let us say we are talking about horizontal circular motion. And in your life, if you see, there are plenty of things in which the thing moves in a circular way. If you see the how washing machine thing operates, that is also a circular motion, right? And how the drum rotates and all. So like that, if you see, you will find plenty of things which has circular motion nature. Now, moving on. In physics, this uniform circular motion is very interesting and very deep, because it involves the concept of vectors and it involves the concept of differentiation also. Okay, so let us try to understand. So as I told you, okay, this is the keyword, speed remain constant in uniform circular motion. So let us say we have a particle and it is going in a circle, and this is my x-axis, this is my y-axis, and let us say for some reason the thing is going, let us say I'm just putting one arrow here, the thing is rotating like this, let us say. Okay, so this is anti-clockwise rotation. So the thing starts, sometimes it's here, and so on. So this is this uniform circular motion is an example of motion in a plane. Okay, so this is an example of motion in a plane. Okay, because it is happening in this xy plane, so that's why it's an example of motion in a plane, just like projectile motion. Okay, if you see that, that is also an example of motion in a plane. Now let us say that this radius of the circle is r, so I am just labeling it here. So radius is, let us say, small r, so it is going in a circle. Now what we have to find is, let us first look in this way, that as the particle is rotating, what thing is changing with time? So let us say, okay, for the time being, it starts from here, t equal to 0, at some time it reaches here, okay, and so on. So as time changes, okay, now time is not going in this way, fine. Suppose I have a clock which reads when t equal to 0, the particle is here, at time t, it is here. So what we will find, that suppose this is my origin, okay, this is 0, 0. And let me just remove this thing. So our particle is going like this, okay, let me just put a arrow in this direction. Now, let us say our particle is going in this way. And so when the particle is here, this is the position vector of the particle, let me write it r vector, fine. And when the particle, after some time it comes here, then this is my r vector. Okay, now what happens during this time, it describes an angle theta. So I will write theta in time t. So you can see, as the particle rotates, what will change is basically r position vector will change and theta. So r and theta will change, or in mathematical terms I can write r and theta are function of time. Now, before talking about this, let me just remind you, this theta is measured in radian. So one complete revolution is 2 pi radian, means one complete rotation is 2 pi radian, fine. So I will just write here, pi radian is equal to 180 degree. So theta is, this is the conversion factor between them. Now, when the particle is here, fine, suppose the particle is here, I can drop a perpendicular here and I can drop a perpendicular here. Let us say at this is point P and the coordinates of particle is xy. Okay, now, so when the particle is here, then you can see I have this triangle R and this is theta. This is x, okay, and this is y. Now you all know this, that if you use this cos theta or sin theta, find sin theta here, so you will find that this triangle x will be equal to r cos theta and y will be equal to r sin theta. Okay, just find sin theta in this triangle and cos theta and you will get it. Now let me write this, that since theta will change with time, this is going to be x at time t will be r cos theta at time t. Okay, and same way y at time t is going to be r sin theta at time t. Now you all know that along x-axis we use I cap. Right, along this we use I cap and along y axis we use j cap. So this r vector, you also know that I can assume it that I am adding this two vector, x vector or x I cap along this, and so using triangle law I can write r vector to be equal to x I plus y j, and
since we are dealing with time, so r at time t is going to be x at time t I cap plus y at time t j cap. Hey, now, so now what I am going to do, I will plug in the numbers here. So x t, now before we move on, okay, let me say this is one equation. So see what is happening, this is the position vector of the particle at time t, which is x at time t or y and so on. Now what will be magnitude of this? Magnitude of position vector will be, okay, you know how to find magnitude, it will be x component square plus y square, or r square equal to x square plus y square. Now this is the second important equation. This is the equation of trajectory. Okay, equation of trajectory in circular motion. That means x can change, y can change, but they add up in such a way that this length of the vector, okay, as it rotates, because circle has a constant radius only, so as it rotates, x and y, they operate in such a way that they add up to this length. Okay, so length remains same as the particle rotates. Now let us move on from there. Now, so okay, now what I can do, I can write r is x, I know what is that, so x is r cos theta I cap plus r sin theta t j cap. Now this is the position vector of the particle in at any time. Okay, we can talk about it. So let us just verify it for once. So at t equal to 0, what is the position vector? So what you do, see, theta is 0 according to our choice. The particle starts from here. So when the particle is here, theta is 0. So this equation, if you apply for t equal to 0, theta is also 0, right? Nah? So if you put theta equal to 0, cos theta is 1, sin theta will be 0. So r at time 0, I am writing, will be, you can see, r I cap. And which is obvious also, this r vector has length r, right? Nah? And it is pointing along I direction. Same way we can do it for others, we will find it out. Okay, so this equation will give you position of the particle at any time. Right, now moving on. Now in vectors, we have learned that what is the, this is position vector. Change in position vector with respect to time will give you velocity vector. So velocity vector is a rate of change of position vector. Okay, now this we are going to apply, but before that, so this is a velocity vector, is rate of change of position vector. Fine. Now before moving on, let us introduce a very important concept which is called angular velocity. Now as we know, velocity is a vector quantity, so it turns out this angular velocity is also a vector quantity, and its direction, okay, its direction is decided, its direction is decided using right hand thumb rule. So let us just understand this. So if you turn your hand so that the curling finger indicates the rotation, the way the particle is going, thumb will indicate the direction of angular velocity. Okay, so right now the angular velocity, since the particle is going in anticlockwise direction, angular velocity is along z cap. Okay, so in this case, angular velocity will denote it by omega vector. Omega vector will be along, okay, I will just write omega
and k cap is the unit vector along z. So omega is going to represent angular velocity, and that is going to be omega, which is the magnitude of angular velocity, and its direction is this. If the particle could have been going in clockwise direction, then it will be in this direction. Okay, so that is the way we decide the angular velocity direction. Now, what happens? It turns out that angular velocity is defined as rate of change of angular displacement. Okay, so just right now I write linear velocity is this. So see the comparison. This is the change in position vector. This is change in theta. Now it turns out, some of you might say that how theta is a vector quantity. It's a very critical issue here. I am not going to touch more there. It turns out that this small change in theta also acts like vector. Okay, so for that reason, a small change in angle is considered as a vector quantity. Okay, so whatever will be the direction of omega will be the direction of theta. So right now, suppose this omega is pointing in this direction, so theta will be also pointing in this direction. Now, moving on. Now, this is the definition of instantaneous angular velocity. This is the general velocity what we know about it. Now, it turns out that if I consider average, okay, omega, I can also use this formula for time being. Okay, just to understand the things better so that we can deal with it. Now, what will be its unit? Theta is measured in radian, as I said, so it will be radian per second. Now, its unit is radian per second. Now, we all can agree that one revolution means 2 pi radian. Okay, one revolution is 2 pi radian. Now, I got a fan recently. It says that its speed is 2200 RPM. Okay, so let us try to understand. So, my fan has a speed 2200 RPM. Let us try to understand the meaning of it. So what will be meaning of it? Now, this is actually what they have given is angular velocity. Okay, so what I do, revolution per minute, but its unit is radian per second, right? So omega is given to be 2200 RPM. Let us convert into radian per second. Now, so 2200 into R is given to be, rotation per, this is revolution per minute. One revolution is 2 pi radian. So I will multiply with 2 pi. And 1 minute is 60 second. I will divide it by 60. Now you can do this maths and find it out. So this will this is 10123 just okay 6, then this is going to be 220 pi by 3, and I don't want to you can use calculator to find it out, and that will be in radian per second, right? So how you convert that into from revolution per minute, you can convert into radian per second or revolution per second. Okay, so that means this number omega has to be measured in radian per second. So whenever you will get RPM, they have given you the meaning of omega actually, and you should convert it using this, that one revolution is 2 pi radian. So this can be converted into this. Okay, now that's about unit of angular velocity. Now if we go to the meaning of it, so see, omega is change in theta by change in time. So suppose I wait for one complete revolution, okay, so t is, let us say, time period. Now we know the meaning of time period. Time period means one complete revolution, right? One time period is, so in one time period, what will be change in angle?
So you can see the change in angle will be, it starts with zero angle, it comes back, that is 2 pi angle. So change in angle will be 2 pi minus 0. What will be change in time period? So it starts from here, comes back here. So change in time period will be t minus 0. So omega is 2 pi by t. Now this is going to be very important for your course. Whenever you talk about waves or simple harmonic motion, anything you will. So this is the relation between omega and time period. So suppose if time period is 1 second, that means it is describing 2 pi radian in 1 second, or it is rotating once it is rotating in 1 second. Okay, one complete revolution is happening in 1 second. Okay, now let me say it again. Suppose if time period comes out to be 1 second, then omega will be 2 pi radian per second. That means that it is describing 2 pi radian, means 360 degree in 1 second. That is the meaning of it. Now, let us move ahead. Now, it turns out that if I use the same concept, omega is equal to, let me use this for this time, it is going from here to here. So, omega, what is the change in angle from here to here? It is theta minus 0 and time is t minus 0. So, omega, I can write it theta by t, or theta can be written as omega into t. Now, before going into anything, let me tell you, omega is a constant thing. Okay, you see, this is changing, this is changing. So in uniform circular motion, omega is going to be constant, fine. So and its unit is, as we talked about, so theta can be manipulated like this. So what we are going to do, r vector, which we wrote r cos theta, I am writing r cos omega t. Okay, and r sin omega t j cap. Now, this looks more nicer than the first one, because here the time is coming out, means automatically. Okay, so theta, we replaced it like this. Now, as I told you, velocity will be given by dr by dt. Okay, now, so what I am going to do, I will differentiate this. So differentiating both sides with respect to time. Okay, so let us say this is equation 1. So we will do differentiate both sides with respect to time. Right. So I will get dr by dt, and this side is d by dt, and in bracket I have r cos omega t I cap plus r sin omega t j cap. Right. Now, if I open the bracket, so this will be dr by dt, this will be d by dt of r cos omega t I cap plus d by dt of r sin omega t j cap. Now, so while differentiating this, okay, let me write down the thing separately. So this one, d by dt of r cos omega t, what will be the answer of it? So see, r is not changing with time, r is nothing but the length, the radius. So r will come out the differentiation. So I will do differentiation of cos omega t, and this result, differentiation of this, I will just write a formula for it. If you have d by dt of cos some constant c,
Okay, let us just write it for this only. So this result is R cos theta differentiation is minus sine omega t and multiplied with omega. So this will give you minus R omega sine omega t. Now, again, if you do the differentiation for this, it turns out that d by dt of R sine omega t, R is constant, it will come outside, will be R omega cos omega t. Now, if I put it back, then I will get, if I put these things back, I will get, so velocity is minus R omega sine omega t I cap plus R omega cos omega t j cap. Now, this will give you velocity at any time t. Okay, so if you we'll see it the whole picture in a moment. Now, moving on, so this will give you velocity at any time. Now, what is acceleration? Acceleration is dv by dt, rate of change of velocity, and it turns out if I differentiate both things with respect to time, if I do the same thing, then dv by dt, and this side, these things are constant, so I will just write down the presentation, d by dt of sine omega t I cap plus R omega d by dt of cos omega t j cap. Now, we know how to differentiate this now, sine omega t or cos omega t. Then if you do the same thing again, then this will come out to be minus omega square R. Okay, so acceleration will be, this whole thing will come out to be minus omega square R cos omega t I cap plus omega square, okay, minus omega square R sine omega t j cap. Okay, so right now what you guys do, you see the differentiation part and reach up to this stage. Okay, I will also recheck, I guess the steps are correct. Now, in the next video, we are going to understand what actually all these terms mean. Okay, and it will be very fascinating actually to know what these terms all stand for. Fine. So I will see you in my next class. Thank you.